Hello friends, good morning. In this video we will see quiz questions on state mission activity. Based on the previous videos we posted, we are going to see this quiz. Friends, if you like this channel, please subscribe and support and click the bell icon to receive the notifications when video is uploaded. Okay, now let us go to the quiz questions. First question, how many sections state activity contains? Entry, exit and transition, transition, entry, exit and final, none of the above. How many sections, friends? 3, entry, exit and transition. Let me show you. If you open any state activity, you can see 3 sections will be there. I'll open the state activity, entry section, exit section and transition section. So this is how in state activity 3 sections will be there. Just I will drag and drop a new state activity. So see, entry, exit, transition. Okay, so the answer is first one, entry, exit and transition. Next question, can state and final activity be included in a sequence? Let us check. I have created a sequence. Let me try to drag and drop state. No, I am not able to include. Let me drag and drop final state. No. Friends, both state and final state activity can be included only in state mission container. So we already saw this in that video. Friends, if you have not watched any video on state missions we posted, please watch this, so that you can easily understand these quiz questions. So inside the state mission container only, you can drag and drop both state and final state activity. So see, now we are able to drag and drop. So what is the answer for that? Answer is no. Can state and final state activity be included in a sequence? No. You can create one initial state but can have more than one final state. True, false. Friends, we saw example with two final states in the last video. See, this is the example we saw in the last video. Here we used two final states. That is, if any error in reading ATM card, it will go to one final state. If the ATM card read is successful and transaction is successful, then it disperses the amount. So based on this, we saw an example in the last video. So state machine can have two final state. Answer is true. And also here, one thing you need to note, you can create only one initial state. There cannot be two initial state. How transition activity designer is created? You can drag and drop transition activity designer from the activity pane. Need to install transition package from manage packages. Transition activity designer is generated when you link one state to another state. What is the answer, friends? So the answer is third one. Transition activity designer is generated when you link one state to another state. So if you open any state activity, you can see transitions here. So it is generated when you linked this state to the distinct state. Let me drag and drop one state. Okay, let me drag and drop another. We'll give this state as state 1. So I have linked state 1 to state 2. Okay. So after linking, while linking, this transition activity designer is created. See, now if you click on this transition activity designer, you can see it is linked to state 2. Now transition activity designer is generated. So the answer is transition activity designer is generated when you link one state to another state. How many sections final state activity is having? 2, 1, 3. Answer is 1. Final state having only entry section trends. If you click on any final state activity we used here, it has only entry section. How many sections transition activity designer has contains? How many sections runs? 3, 2, 1. Answer is 3. Okay. Just go to the transition activity designer, any transition click. You can see trigger, condition, action. Source and destination is automatically generated when you click link one state to another. So the three sections are in transition activities: trigger, condition, action. So answer is 3. What are the available sections in the transition activity designer? Just we saw, friends, trigger, action, condition. So answer is first one. If the condition in the transition designer is true, which section will get executed? Exit section and then action section, action section, entry section. What is the answer, friends? We saw in the video, if the condition used in the transition is true, then bot executes the exit section and then will come to the action section and then execute what is activity is contained in the action section. So the answer is exit section and then action section. Friends, this is explained in the previous videos. So if you are not sure about this, please watch that video. I have also given the descriptions of the two videos we posted earlier in the description link. What are the available sections in the final state activity? So previously you saw many sections, one. Now it is only entry. Open. Go to the final state. You can see only entry section is there. Is it mandatory any activity is included under trigger section? Yes. Then only bot can evaluate the condition to be true or false. No, typically trigger is an activity that waits for some type of event to occur, but it can be any activity or no activity at all. If there is no trigger activity, then condition is immediately evaluated. Friends, the answer is no. For this also we saw the same example, that is we used a Scott read successfully an assign activity. Okay. We also declared that condition in the variable pen instead of in trigger activity. We saw this example. Okay, so it is not mandatory that you need to give value under trigger section. So answer is no. There is no condition declared in the transition activity designer. What would happen? Bot throws a validation message saying condition must be declared. Bot executes the activity under exit section and then executes the activity under action section and control passes to target state. Bot executes the activity under activity section. What is the answer, friends? Answer is second one. Bot executes the activity under exit section and then executes the activity under action section and control passes to target state. So if no condition is declared, bot simply executes what all the activities we included under exit section and then goes to action section. We explained this in state ATM. We saw this example in the previous video. Anyway, I will open and show it to you. See here, in initial state we just put message box reading ATM card, exiting from reading state. If you see, we have not used any condition. In this example, bot just executes the activity under exit section, then comes to the action section and displays this message box. So answer is second one. What is self transition? Initial state is called a self transition. A transition is transits from a state to itself, none of the option. So answer is second one. This is called a self transition. That is transition which transits from a state to itself. Both are self transition. We call it this. Will transition occurs if the declared condition is evaluated to false? No. And yes. Answer, what is the difference? Answer is no. Because if you have declared any condition, then it must evaluate to true. Otherwise, the control will be keep on passing to the trigger. For example, if this condition is not true, then control will be keep on going to the trigger part. Transition will not occur. So whatever the declared, if you have declared any condition, it must be true. Can more than one transition share the same trigger event? One transition share the same trigger event? Yes. This is called add shared trigger transition. We also saw an example for that shared transition. If you click in the transition activity designer, we have used more than one transition which shared the same trigger event. So answer is true. Thank you friends, hope this video is useful to you. If you like this channel, please subscribe and support and encourage friends. Thank you.